So just logged into my Teespring account and I went to the get paid section. I just want to scroll down here and show that I do have a lot of proof of sales from previous campaigns I've ran. You can see there's one here of 3,000, 2,000 here, another one there, 2,000, 1,400, another $1,000 one there, 2,000, lots of $1,000 campaigns. There's a $5,000 one there. I'll be going through some of these in the case study section. So 4,000, there was an $11,000 one, one of my better ones there, 8,000, $34,000 one. These are all 7-day campaigns. And you can see another 10,000 there, another 11,000, 3,000, there's a 24,000, 35,000. Now a lot of these big ones here are ones that I don't really want to reveal, just in case I want to rerun them or do something more with that niche. But I'm definitely going to show some of the other campaigns here, like, and show you how like a full case study. I'm basically just going to show you the money in, money out, and show you the ad and copy and all that kind of stuff for some of these campaigns. But anyhow, I definitely will show a bunch of these in here and show that I am currently making money with Teespring. Well, actually, at the moment, the money that we're only making is from what I've been doing for this course. But I'll always continue to do a little bit here or there within Teespring. But to be honest, my main passion is designing software, and I'm going to continue designing software and create online projects and things like that that are not to do with Teespring. So Teespring sort of just a side thing, but I just want to do a quick little video here for a couple minutes to show you that I've actually did make nearly $250,000 using Teespring. Actually, let's just take a look at exactly how much I've made, because I keep saying it's around $250,000, but I don't think it's quite that much. It's less than that. I haven't looked for a while, so let's just take a look here. The way to do it, I'm going to open up, I went into my Firefox browser, because it actually works better in Firefox to select data for this sort of thing. So you notice that when you go to select, say you want to get all these numbers out of here, when you go to select something, it selects it like the whole line. When it looks like the data's like organized in columns on a web page like this, what you can do in Firefox is hold down the control key and then left click and drag, and you notice it selects cells. So that's a handy little thing with Firefox, I've noticed. Let's go ahead and grab all of these, and I'm gonna right click and copy. And you notice that in here there's some that are in brackets and some that are not. This amount with the plus, this is the amount of money that has been made from that shirts, from the shirts, and then this is the amount that has been released and paid to me. So when you drop this into, or paste this into Excel, oh, it was like a right click and paste, you'll notice that those paid amounts will go as negative, but it doesn't matter. Like, the negative amounts and the positive amounts, they all equal the same thing. So let me just show you what I mean. So if I just take this column and I can, what you want to do is you want to separate the negatives from the positives. Just select that column, and then in Excel under the editing, sort it from largest to smallest, and now they'll be sorted out. So what I can do is I can actually take, if I select the first red one and go down the bottom, select it, the last one there, let's just move this whole selection to the top. I'll just show you. So if we take this whole column, just select it all and hit the summation, it'll sum up all of those. Let's take how much, look, I didn't do that here, sorry. Grab the first cell, go down to the bottom here, now hit the summation button there. So it's actually about $230,000, so not quite $250,000, but still $230,000 is pretty good. I'm curious, I want to see and make sure that these add up the same. So if I take all the red ones and just add them up, it should be the same number but negative. Oh, it's not. That means there must have been some bonus money in there or something like that that I got. Sometimes they add that little bonus, so looks like it's about, what is the exact difference? I can tell you right now. So if we an equal sign, let's take How do I do that? This one minus this one. Oh, that's not gonna work. I think you just add them together, I mean, because one is negative. I just want to see the difference here. It's $2,000 difference there. Interesting. So I guess I got $2,000 extra for something. Must have been some, you know, they add that little bit of bonus money when you go over your goal. That's what I'm guessing. So anyhow, 230 grand basically in there. So it's not quite 250,000, but I'll be making more money in the future. So I'm sure I'll hit 250 grand and probably within the next month or so. All right, so I'll go ahead and show you some of these campaigns in the case study section.